Myth. The Dream Act will result in mass amnesty. Fact. No one automatically receives a green card through the act. Myth. The Dream Act will spur more illegal immigration. Fact. The act offers no incentives for more illegal immigrants. In order to qualify, you must have moved to the U.S. before 16 years of age. Myth. The Dream Act allows criminals and gang members to avoid the law. Fact. Immigrants convicted of crimes are ineligible for the Dream Act. Like many people before, I was informed, I was extremely skeptical of the Dream Act, which is an acronym for Development, Relief, and Education for Alien Minors. Essentially, what this bill would do is allow undocumented immigrants who meet a number of qualifications allow them to attend an institution of higher learning. I had the chance to go on a life-changing service trip to Apopka, Florida during spring break of my junior year in high school, where I lived and worked with migrant farmers. After meeting some of the youths in this situation, my mindset completely changed. In fact, the Dream Act can help our country in a number of ways. According to the Center of American Progress, the Dream Act would boost the economy by $329 billion and create 1.4 million new jobs by 2030. Sold me on the Dream Act was many of the kids that I met at the Hope Community Center. This center is for youths who are struggling, and Sister Ann Kendrick of the Notre Dame Saints is there as the rock in their life. One kid I met, Vinny, told me a very inspiring story. He was 6 when he left his home country of Guatemala, and he doesn't remember much, but he does remember that his father tried to make their lives better by moving them to the United States. They tried doing it in an illegal manner, yet the government of the United States kept denying them. So, eventually, they decided to move here illegally. Vinny vividly recounts driving in a truck, having to be completely silent, and his father taking him out, walking him across the river, and getting into another truck to get into the United States. The story touched my heart, and seeing the man Vinny has become today, it is just terrible to see that he is not able to get a higher education. Vinny is very similar to myself. He had a 3.7 grade SAT scores, but as he graduated my year, I'm here at Syracuse University, and he is taking classes at community college and working his father's repair shop. It is devastating to see these youths have to take the punishment that their parents' mistakes, and I really hope to invigorate this youth so they see that they have something to fight for and that they should and do